bringing children to him in order that he might touch them. And the disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not stop them, for it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly, I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. JP and Bucky, in gratitude for the gift of John Philip Elisha Fultz, you present him today to the Lord in dependence on God's grace. Will you endeavor by example and teaching to provide him with a home of faith and love, that he may know throughout his childhood and growth into adulthood the warmth, hope, and freedom of the Christian faith, that he may welcome life's beauty, learn from its pain, and share in its joys, that his love for others may deepen with knowledge and insight of every kind, that he may discover what is the breadth and length and height and depth of the love of God and of Jesus Christ, through whom God has made such love known, that his life may be open to the grace and purpose of God and to the call of God's Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. If so, answer, "With God's help, we will." Congregation, and with all of you who belong to this church and are gathered here on this day, seek to be a community through which Elisha can discover the meaning of Christian faith and stir into flame the gifts which God has given him, whatever they may be. Repeat after me, "With God's help, we will." Congregation, do you promise as a community of faith to surround the Fultz family with your love for the strengthening of their life together, to be for these parents and their children a family in Christ whose love for them cannot be broken, to accept Elisha into your loving care and share the responsibility for him to grow toward fullness of life in Christ, to help him learn Christ's ways and to lead him in service to God and neighbor? If so, repeat after me, "We do, with God helping us."
We do, with God helping us.
Do I get to take him? Hi. Oh my goodness. How are you?
Oh my goodness.
John Philip Elisha Fultz, I'm going to anoint your head with oil. We'll put a little cross on your head in the name of God, the Father, and the Son, and Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Amen. And we pray that throughout your life, the Lord blesses you and watches over you, and that God's grace will shine upon you and be gracious to you, and the Lord look kindly on you and always give you peace. I'm holding you in a way that you would rather not be held, so I'll give you back to Mom. I'll do the prayer afterwards.
This is my fourth child now who I get to sing to. If you know the chorus, I'll ask you to sing with me when we get there. But something that just struck me as I was reviewing the verse again, it says, "I know who holds your future. Life is worth living just because he lives." And so I want you to all be encouraged that your life is worth living just because he lives. And this boy's life is worth living just because he lives. And you see, my family, their lives are worth living because he lives. We have a great heritage because he lives. How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy he gives, but greater still the calm assurance this child can face uncertain days because he lives. sing with me. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know who holds his future.
I think that is a prayer in itself, and we want to, Becky, if you can just show him. Anyway, we want to introduce you to John Philip Elisha Fultz this morning. Thanks be to God for him and his family. Amen. What an excellent time to share in a dedication of a child, as we also are sharing in things we have to be thankful for. So we are definitely thankful for children and new life. Hear these words from Colossians 3, and let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your heart, sing psalms, hymns, spiritual songs to God in whatever you do in the word of the Father. Do deed to everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. So gratitude, as we go through these our worship service this morning, I hope you sense that spirit of gratitude that is present. And gratitude is mentioned in the Bible over 150 times. It's important. Every time that you hear the liturgy for communion, you hear of what Jesus did first, which was to give thanks. Give thanks for the bread, give thanks for the wine. He always went and gave thanks to the Father, which is a reminder to us. And so it's mentioned over 150 times. Gratitude is a choice. It's a choice. We get to choose how we will respond to a situation. Gratitude comes from God's word. And as we humbly study God's word, we see things more as God sees them. We recognize his grace in all things. And we can't help but be more thankful. We are reassured that the Lord is in control and loves us. He has a plan for us as we seek him. Gratitude is worship of God. Thanks be to God.
When troubles come,
your voices and lift them high. again, and of course, welcome to Belmont United Methodist Church. We are so happy to have you here this morning, and if you are a guest, a first-time visitor, we do have a special gift just for you, so please see an usher for that before you leave. You know, we've already talked about this, of course, is a day of music and gratitude. We've got a lot of gratitude themes to be thankful for. We're going to be thanking God for his love, his provision, for our salvation, for God's empowerment, and of course, above all else, God's presence in our lives. But of course, for this service to really work, we all got to participate together, of course. We want to worship together. So we're going to invite you to stand at this time, and we're going to be celebrating God's love. That's our first theme in this song, Better Than Life. We encourage you to join with us and sing along with it.
Better than life. Oh, 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 better than life.
Lord Jesus, we thank you that you are better than life, that you have given us a gorgeous day, that you've given us heat, that you have given us all that we need, and that most of all, you have given yourself to be the sacrificial lamb so that we might have life. Lord God, we just thank you for so many blessings. We praise your holy name, for it is your name that should be praised. And so, God, we come before you this morning to give you thanks, to lift our voices, to lift our songs, to lift instruments, to lift our very selves to you in honor and glory of who you are and whose we are when we give our lives to you. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We pray that your name is always on our lips to praise. In Jesus' name we pray.
Rock, water in the stone, man on the ground, no matter where I go, I don't need to worry now that I know. Everything I need you've got, there's honey in the rock. Begging for a miracle, thirsty for the living well, only you can satisfy. Sweetness at the mercy seat, now taste it, it's not hard to see, only you can satisfy. There's honey in the rock, there's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock.
Freedom where the spirit is. Bounty in the wilderness. You will always satisfy. Yeah. There's honey in the rock. Water in the stone. Man on the ground. No matter where I go, I don't need to worry.
Providing, I'm all that I need. You are all that I need.
I keep praying, I keep moving, I keep praising, you keep proving. I'm all that I need.
You are all that I need.
So I keep looking, I keep finding, you keep giving, keep providing.
I'm all that I need. it is to trust in you, Jesus. Oh, how sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus. Oh, how sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus.
We were broken, sinful, and wretched. A stain soaked deep into the fabric of humanity. Consumed by death, covered in darkness, lost in the wilderness, set adrift in the vastness. But God, He was consumed too. Unwilling to watch His creation wander endlessly. Unable to sit by as we dove deeper into the abyss. He was overcome by love, by grace, by mercy. He took our pieces and gave them purpose. He took our shattered spirit and gave it hope. He took our destiny and reshaped it. Though we were unworthy, He counted us worthwhile. We were broken, but in the hands of God, we've been made whole.
I was a wretch, I remember who I was. I was lost, I was blind, I was running out of time. Sin separated, the breach was far too wide. But from the far side of the chasm, you held me in your sight. So you made a way across the great divide. Left behind heaven's throne to build it here inside. And there at the cross, you paid the debt I owed. Broke my chains, freed my soul. For the first time I had hope. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood applied. Thank you, Jesus, it has washed me white. Thank you, Jesus, you have saved my life. Tomb of sin. You were buried for 3 days, but then you walked right out again. Now death has no sting, and life has no end. For I have been transformed by the blood of to glory. brought me from the darkness into glorious light. Glory to His name. Glory to His name. There to my heart was the blood applied. Glory to His name.
We thank You, Father, for the love and mercy that You showed us. Thank You for Your salvation. We thank You that You made a way for us. Hallelujah.
That song we just sang was talking about Jesus and His salvation. He was buried, 3 days He rose again. That same power lives in us. And so this coming song, the song Ain't No Grave, that's what that's about. If you have Jesus living inside of you, if you've asked the Holy Spirit to rain down upon you, He gives you power. And we've talked about miracles over the last 3 weeks, and there are over 125 miracles, but only about 37 of them are about Jesus. That same power God plants into people. And Jesus even told the disciples, He said, go, you're going to do greater things than this. You're going to do greater things. So when we sing, if you feel like you're 6 feet under, there ain't no grave gonna hold you in there. There ain't no grave because of the power of Jesus.
Shame is a prison as cruel as a grave. Shame is a robber and he's come to take my name. Oh, love is my redeemer, lifting me up from the ground. Love is the power where my freedom song is found. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. When I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise up out of the ground. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down.
No. there was a battle, a war between death and life. There on the tree, the Lamb of God was crucified, and he went on down to hell. He took back every key.
Great time of celebration here together. All the things that we have to be grateful for. Amen. So I know, of course, we want to acknowledge there's some people that, you know, it may just feel like I don't have anything to be grateful for. You know, nothing's going right in my life. Everything's broken, you know. And if you're in that situation, you know, you're thinking, why should we feel thankful? And we feel left behind or forgotten. And I was thinking about that this week, and I was reminded in the Psalms of how David turned to God when he felt forsaken. David always turned to the presence of God. And Psalm 23 writes, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me." In another Psalm, Psalm 42, he writes, "I say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why must I walk about mournfully? Because the enemy oppresses me. As with a deadly wound in my body, my adversaries taunt me, while they say to me continually, 'Where is your God? Why are you cast down, O my soul? Why are you disquieted within me?' Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God." How was David able to pray a prayer like this? You could see everything was going wrong for David. Nothing was right. What enabled him to say, "I shall again praise him"? How did he have that next level of gratitude? And that's where God wants to take us, I believe. God wants to take us to a next level, beyond just thanking God for his blessings. You know, we've talked about God's love, his mercy, his provision, and we should be thankful for all those things, of course. But there's another level past that, going beyond just a transactional relationship with the Lord. You know, it's not just, "God, you bless me, and I'll say nice things about you." It's in the midst of the heartache, in the midst of everything going wrong, in the midst of everything being broken, that David said, "I shall praise him again." See, there's a secret there to David's gratitude. And it's right in that same psalm where he says, "I will praise you, yet I will praise you." And he starts out and he says, "As a deer longs for flowing streams, so my soul longs for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God." David understood the fullness, the richness of God's presence. That even when he didn't see the blessings, even when he didn't see the provision, he didn't feel God's love or mercy, he understood the fullness, the richness of God's presence. It's the same thing as in the story of Mary and Martha, when when Mary was just wanted to sit at Jesus' feet and Martha was upset she wasn't doing any of the work going on. And Jesus said that Mary understands what's right here. Mary understands what's most important. It's the very presence of Jesus that fills our hearts. It's the very presence of God in our life. More than any blessing that we may seek from God, it's his presence. We talked again about his love, his provision, his mercy, his grace, his salvation, and our empowerment through him. But that all ultimately serves a greater purpose. The reason why we have all those things is to take us back to the presence of God. Because nothing else matters. That's what this next song is about. Just being in Jesus' presence. Thankful, grateful for the presence of the Lord.
I'm caught up in your presence. I just wanna sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never wanna leave. Oh, I'm not here for blessings. Jesus, you don't owe me anything more than anything that you can do. I just want you.
And I'm sorry when I've just gone through the motions. I'm sorry just sing another song. Take me back to where it started. I open up my heart to you. I'm caught up in your presence. I just want to sit here at your feet. Caught up in this holy moment, never wanna leave.
Sing this together.
Oh, I'm not here for blessings. 'Cause Jesus, you don't owe me anything more than
just want you, nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do.
You've been feeling like you've had a lot of distractions. lot else going on to take you away from the Lord's presence. If you've never experienced that presence before, but you're saying, I want to know the richness and the fullness of God's love today. Well, we invite you at this time, if you feel like it, you could come and be prayed for. Pastor Jan and Becky will move over to the side here. And if you want to come over, you'll have to come over this way. As we continue to sing this song, we just want to pray a prayer of a blessing over you. You can know God's presence, experience His richness, His fullness, and His love in this place, at this time. Nothing else matters. You can come forward anytime you feel ready. Nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing else will do. When I've come with my agenda, I'm sorry. When I forgot that you're enough, so take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. Caught up in your presence. I just want to sit here at your feet, caught up in this holy, never want to leave. Cause I'm not here for blessings, Jesus, you don't know me.
Chronicles 16:29 says, give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Bring an offering and come before him worship the Lord in beauty of holiness. We are invited in scriptures to bring our offerings, bring our gifts, and bring them to the Lord. And that should come out of our gratitude for who God is and for what God has done and for the blessings that we see in our lives. And so what we give is up to what we feel in our hearts. We may give more of our gifts. We may give offerings. We may give our service. But we come and we give out of gratitude to the Lord. Thanks be to God.
We'll invite our ushers forward at this time to take in our morning offering.
Do you feel the world is broken?
We do.
Do you feel the shadows deepen?
We do.
And do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through?
We do.
Do you wish that you could see it all made new? Is all creation groaning?
It is.
Is a new creation coming?
It is.
Is the glory of the Lord to be the light within our midst?
It is.
Do you wish that you could remind ourselves of this? It is.
Conquered the grave.
Dear Lord, we thank you for all the gifts that you've given us. And through all the struggles, you still give and give and charge us to give as well. Give us the strength to support each other, to love each other as you've shown us. And thank you for all that you've done for the least of these. It's in your word and image that we try to live to the same standard. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Amen.
Well, we've got one more song we want to sing together, and I think it's a favorite around here. So, please stand with us as you're able. We're going to close out by singing Good God Almighty.
Good God Almighty, I hope you'll find me. Praise your name no matter what comes, 'cause I know where I'd be without your mercy. So I keep praising your name at the top of my lungs.
Well, I can't count the times I've called your name some broken night. You showed up and patched me up like you do every time I
get amnesia. And I forget that you keep coming around.
Yeah, ain't no way you'll ever let me. Somebody that you're not.
Like the sun in the morning, I know you're gonna be there every day.
So what on earth could make me be afraid?
Good God Almighty, I hope you'll find me. Praising your name no matter what comes, 'cause I know where I'm. Keep praising your name at the top of my lungs.
Tell me, is he good?
He's good.
Tell me, is he God?
He's God.
He is
good God Almighty. Praise him in the morning, praise him in the noontime, praise him when the sun goes down. Love him in the morning, love him in the noontime, love him when the sun goes down. Good God Almighty. Jesus when the sun goes down. Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime, Jesus when the sun goes down.
We just want to tell you a couple of things before you leave this morning. One is a thank you to everyone who participated in the shoeboxes for children. There were 100 boxes delivered this past Friday. So that is awesome. And then a couple of things that are ahead of us. December 2nd is our church gathering. And if you're here, you're welcome to come on December 2nd. It's in your bulletin for our Christmas party beginning at 2 o'clock. And so find that in your bulletin. And also December 6th is our coming together to meet Santa for Belmont. And so that will be, Becky told me, 3 o'clock. 3 o'clock on December 6th to Santa Visits Belmont. We need cookies to share with others. And so if you can be part of that, that would be awesome. And so now as we close, in thankfulness of hearts, we give thanks to God. We ask you to go in peace and joy and love and finding those blessings that God has given to you and be a blessing to others. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good God Almighty, I hope you'll find me praising your name. Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime, Jesus when the sun goes.